It's been a while now since I posted a Notion tutorial. I've been busy working with clients, building awesome Notion workspaces, among other things, and I've been learning a lot about how Notion can be used in interior design businesses. When I start working with clients, the number one comment that they make to me is that Notion is too overwhelming and confusing. If you've been watching a few Notion videos, you might be feeling the same thing. However, the good news is that even though a function may be available, you don't have to use it. The major mistake that my clients make is adding too many databases and functionality, making their pages too complex before they've even had time to practice or get used to it. I'm here to show you that it doesn't have to be this way. In this video, I'm going to give you some tips that I share with my interior design clients that will show you how you can supercharge your Notion workspace to help you organize and streamline your interior design business without the overwhelm. So, are you ready to streamline your workflow, organize your schedules, and enhance client collaboration with ease? Let's dive into how Notion can be your ultimate tool for success in the world of interior design. First, let's talk about crafting functional dashboards and templates in Notion. These are your command centers where efficiency meets your creativity. Every dashboard should start with some key databases. Let's jump into my Notion workspace for interior designers and take a look. I recommend only starting with a few databases and keeping them all in one area. The most useful databases are the Action Task database and the Projects database. And I like to keep them as linked views on most of my functional dashboards. So what is a functional dashboard? I believe that most of the complex tasks that we complete in a day have a workflow, and this workflow should be streamlined and repeatable. We can create dashboards that help us get through these tasks. Now, before I move on to the next tip, if you want to learn more about building your own interior design workspace in Notion, then make sure you check out this video where you'll find a link in my description for the full Notion workspace that I create. And of course, if you're finding this content useful, please like and subscribe. There's lots more on the way. Just this week, Notion released a calendar integration function, which means that we can now see calendars that we set up in Notion in a standalone Notion calendar app. So, just a bit of background. Back in 2022, Notion acquired Cron, a beautiful calendar interface that you could link to a Google Calendar. This week, Notion re-released Cron as a new standalone calendar app. I'm not going to do a deep dive into the Notion calendar app here, but essentially, if you have a calendar view of a main database, you'll see this little calendar button here, which allows you to see these tasks in the new Notion calendar. The inbuilt Notion calendar was always a bit clunky, especially for setting dates and times. However, if you link your calendar view to the app, it will appear, and then you can drag in the tasks into your Notion calendar, making setting time and dates so much easier. This means if you have a specific project database, you can create a calendar view, link it to your Notion calendar app, and play around with scheduling. Easy. One other cool feature is that you can integrate your meeting client, such as Zoom or Google Meet, into the calendar, making scheduling meetings a breeze. And finally, you can share your availability with staff and clients for meetings and schedule them by just sending them a link. So easy. The next tip I have for you when it comes to supercharging your Notion interior design business workspace is resource storage. As designers, we collect so much information and we need to make that information accessible to ourselves, our team, and our clients. This knowledge is part of our IP. Establishing a knowledge database or databases makes this easy. As I said before, I like to keep the number of databases I create at a minimum, but you can make an exception for databases that are pertinent to a particular project. As I've shown, one thing I love about Notion is the ability to filter, sort, and search for information. You can create many different views and filter and sort information, making accessing them now and in the future easy. Notion's search feature is very useful and uses AI to search through all the pages that you created to find pages related to your search. And finally, communication. Notion is the perfect place to communicate with your clients. One of the key things to consider when designing your client portal is to make it as simple as possible, especially if your client has not used Notion before. Let's take a look at an example client portal to see what we should include. The key to an effective client portal is to keep it simple. In my client portal, we have a navigation page, which we have the introduction where the clients can find invoices, documents, updates, meeting schedules, a project timeline, a place to communicate and have ideas, project planning, orders and budgeting, place your testimonials, contacts and frequently asked questions. The goal of a client portal is to allow your clients to keep all the information in one place so that nothing is missed and that your path and communication channels are left clear and easy to understand. We always include lots of videos in the client portal for our clients to learn how to use it. Notion has so many more use cases in your interior design businesses. I always recommend starting small and building up your skills from there. By concentrating on building functional dashboards, you can ensure a quality design service that is consistent and organized. I help many interior designers set up their Notion dashboards, and I've learned a lot with these very, very simple rules. To sum up, Notion is more than just an organizational tool. It's your powerful ally in your interior design business. You can not only keep your information, but make that information accessible and powerful. If you found these tips helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more insights on elevating your interior design business. Thank you for watching. And remember, with Notion at your side and a bit of creativity, your design business can reach new heights. See you in the next video.